Okay, so hello everyone, and welcome to MYBC Consulting's Where in the World is Jeanette Martin of MYBC Consulting? Well, today, guess what, guys? I'm still in my kitchen from my home office, and my phone is talking to me, so I'm going to be kind to you and shut this off. And I just want to go deeper with people, and those that know me well, the basis of my soul is collaboration, community, and connection. And when I can know people a lot better by their W5 story in one of those, and you are in my connections group. So I would like to W5 the person that's right over here. And so, who are you?
Hi.
Yeah, who are you?
I'm your table buddy. Remember us at the meetings?
Yes. I miss that. And you know what? I have an empty chair right here too.
Hey, okay. All right then. Okay. Besides that, my name is Adrian Starks. I am a keynote speaker. I am a personal development coach, an author, and I'm the founder of Champion Up. I'm also a fiance to a wonderful businesswoman that you know. And I also am an owner of my own business, and I own another business, and I happen to be a brother, a son, a loyal citizen to the world.
Woo-hoo!
And just a go-getter out here, you know, a creator of change. That's who I am.
Absolutely. So in some of those who roles, what are some things you do?
So one of the things that I do is I actually inspire people, whether that be teams, organizations, groups, students. I go and I speak to them about changes and challenges and how to cope with those, and also how to get through it, because we are living in a time right now where it's all about challenges. And I believe right now it's a great time for us to exercise courage. So that's one of the things that I do. I also speak on podcasts. I talk about bringing wonderful people like yourself on, you know, the ideas that you have and you're sharing around the world and helping make this world a better place. So I do that as well. I also exercise, enjoy nature, enjoy wonderful conversations.
And I know one of your who's were aligned. We are citizens of a great cup of coffee. I know we share that in common as our
we
who's
certainly do.
We like to do. We both love to drink a great cup of coffee.
Oh, yeah. Love it.
Yes. So where do you do some of the who's?
Well, I do it across the world. I do some of it here in Canada. I do some of it in the US. I do a lot of it online. So pretty much I'm a traveling speaker. And my podcast is virtual, so pretty much I'm touching every part of the world that I can. And that's the whole purpose of why I do what I do.
Isn't it amazing? I think about, I've been talking to people lately, about a couple of years ago, and I just came to this incredible epiphany that these platforms and technology is so abundant. Like,
yes,
and I gave such credit to the universe or God, or whoever I call God, that thank you for that person in the world that wanted to make Facebook, that wanted to make LinkedIn, that created Twitter, that created Facebook, that created these platforms of abundance that we can share our stories to the four corners of this round world. Like, how incredible is that?
You know, in 1961, JF Kennedy, when he wanted to send man to the moon, people thought he was crazy. And he had this vision about technology, where it's going, right? When that happened, things changed. And now we are feeling we're actually getting all of this from technology, to being able to contact each other, to do business online, to see our family members. You know, I've been able to see my family online more often now than ever.
Oh, that's so true. I've had so many birthday parties and things like that. So our where, we used to think our where was like this, and now our where is like this, and now our where is like this. So the next question, when did you decide to be that who, doing what you're doing, and where you're doing? When did you decide
Four years ago. I worked in the call center in Seattle for 8 long years, and I was never really happy there. I ran a very stressful group known as the orthopedics department, a very stressful part of the hospital. And I was great at what I did, but I just wasn't happy. Things changed when I realized that I want to explore more of speaking in front of people and inspiring on my own personal level. So in 2018, I went on a trip to Florence, Italy, and I took it was a personal development trip where I went with a small group of business owners, and it was led by one person. Her name is Michelle Falcone, or actually two people, Michelle Falcone and Karen McGregor, but Michelle Falcone ran this session in particular, and she had a session called Let It Go. This was before the movie, right? Before
Okay, Frozen. Yeah. You know, that song is going in my head, but thank you.
Right, Let It Go, Let It Go. Yeah. So let it go. And it was in that moment, we were in a Roman spa in Assisi, Italy, all six of us. And I realized I got to quit my job. Oh. I've got to explore what I need to explore and to go out here in the world and speak to people and inspire them to create their own changes. So I made a mark. That was in May of 2018. I said, when I get back to work, I'm going to set a date. I set a date for September 14th of 2018. So literally 4 months later, I quit my job.
Wow.
And I went out and I started building my business. Excellent. Piece by piece, relationship by relationship. And here we are today in 2020 with me being able to do this even during the pandemic.
Absolutely. So the last question we always wrap up with, and we all know that if we are not really clear, both in reality and what we communicate online, the BS factor, because no one likes to be called BS. So what is your why? Like, why all of this that you're creating your life?
I want humanity to be better. I want human beings to know that it's more than being, it's becoming. And that in order for us to make this world a better place, we have to become better as a whole. And that means that we have to live a life of courage, not out of fear. And how do we live through courage? By making our own changes that resonate with us. So I am here on this planet simply to allow people to become champions in their own personal lives and to show them that your life does not have to be a drudgery. It can actually be exciting, it can be adventurous, and more importantly, you can make an impact on the world. That's why I'm here.
So just beautiful. So there's a great why. And I'd like to thank Adrian for coming on. I have known Adrian for about 2 years now, I think.
Yes, and 2 years. Time flies.
Oh, and been my table buddy. And as a lot of you know, I am the creator and the co-founder for the Gratitude and Appreciation Summits that are coming up. And on October the 3rd, Mr. Adrian Starks is one of our guest speakers. Yeah, you. Yeah, you signed up, buddy. You're on. You're on the docket. We're so glad, Kathy Fester and I, that you have decided to evolve into what the summits are going to be looking like. They were going to be in person. And we just want to make the world better. My why, as you all know, is helping others share their stories to the four corners of this round world with the foundation of gratitude and appreciation. And I got to bring people along with me because Adrian has taught me within his W5 story how to be a better person. And I'm so grateful you took your time today. It's very short, but it's very insightful. And if you want to get to know Adrian more, please reach out to him. And I want to say again, thank you for your time today and go enjoy the sunshine. And please give that lovely fiance of yours a hug.
Will do.
Katie and Jeremy of Chewy Media work on my website. So I look good because of them. Mm-hmm. So I've got a bunch of great people I'm connected to, and I'm building this incredible community. So thank you so much, Adrian. Again, I'm so grateful. And we'll see you again next Monday. Not sure what time, because it depends on the person I work within their schedule, for another episode of Where in the World is Jeanette Martin, learning somebody's W5 story. Bye-bye, everybody.